Hello and welcome to Dental Studies Simplified. I'm Dr. Ankita Kotecha and today's topic is a requested topic, microbial organization in dental plaque at varying levels of pocket depth. This topic is relevant for postgraduate examinations and for undergraduate examinations, maybe in their viva voce. This topic will be dealt under the following subheadings, that is a brief discussion on the statistics, that is the number of microorganisms in dental plaque, a brief discussion on the types of the dental plaque, followed by a detailed discussion on the microbial composition, that is a stratified organization of the microorganisms in supragingival plaque, followed by subgingival plaque. And I'll end the discussion with clinical importance. Okay, now talking about the microbial organization in dental plaque, that means dental plaque is primarily composed of microorganisms, mainly bacteria. There are many other non-bacterial species, to name archaea, fungi, viruses and protozoa. Okay, these are the other non-bacterial strains available in or present in dental plaque. So primarily composed of microorganisms, 1 gram, that is a wet weight of dental plaque, 1 gram of dental plaque may contain 10 raised to 11 bacteria. This is the number of microorganisms, that is bacteria, present in 1 gram of wet weight dental plaque. Okay, now we all know there are mainly two types of plaque, supragingival and subgingival. Talking about the supragingival plaque, that is present on a single tooth surface. Mind you, I am talking about single tooth surface, not the entire tooth. A single tooth surface, supragingival plaque present on single tooth surface may contain microorganisms almost 10 raised to 9 or more. That is 10 raised to 9 bacteria. And if we talk about subgingival, that is present in the pockets or a sulcus, the range is 10 raised to 3 bacteria in a healthy sulcus and may range up to more than 10 raised to 8 bacteria in a pathologically deepened sulcus called pocket. So these are the few numbers that revolves around the number of bacteria in a plaque. One more number to remember. See, this is an interesting update. If you read Carranza 10th edition, it is mentioned more than 500 species. But the 13th edition Carranza tells almost 750 species of microorganisms are present. That is 750 microbial phylotypes. Okay, this includes all bacteria and the other non-bacterial organisms such as archaea, fungi, viruses and protozoa. Okay, and this is because of the advent or the update or the advancement in the technology, the molecular techniques and the microbiological investigations. That is how they came up with identification of more and more types of microorganisms associated or present in plaque. That is why this number is updated in 10th edition and 13th edition. In 10th edition it says more than 500, but the 13th edition says as much as 750 types. And so it is obvious any individual arbitrarily, randomly may harbor as much as hundreds of species. Okay, so almost 100, in terms of hundreds, I'm not telling just hundreds, it can be 100, 200, 300, 400 and so on. Okay, because as many as 750 types of microorganisms are identified in the plaque. So these are the few numbers that we are supposed to know about when it comes to dental plaque. Okay, now talking about the types of the dental plaque, just a brief summary, because my main topic here is the microbial organization. Do let me know in the comment section if you want me to discuss dental plaque or biofilm related, any questions, queries or any subtopic. Okay, today I will discuss mainly the microbial organization. So coming to the types of dental plaque, mainly two types based on its location: supragingival, subgingival. Its location in relation to the gingival margin. So plaque that is present on the tooth surface above or at the gingival margin is called supragingival plaque. whereas the plaque that is present below the gingival margin, that is between the tooth and the pocket epithelium or the sulcular epithelium, is called subgingival plaque. There is one more type of plaque here. As I mentioned, supragingival plaque is the plaque located at or above the gingival margin. So the plaque that is present at the margin is called as marginal plaque, and this marginal plaque is responsible for the initiation of the disease gingivitis. We have a entity called marginal gingivitis. So this is the classification of the dental plaque: supragingival, subgingival, and at gingival margin is called marginal plaque, which is responsible for gingivitis, precisely marginal gingivitis. Okay, so we have completed till now the introductory statistics of dental plaque and the types of dental plaques. Now we will proceed to the main part, that is the microbial organization of plaque, that is supragingival and subgingival. So first we will discuss the supragingival microbial stratified organization. As you can appreciate, in this supragingival tooth associated supragingival plaque, we have two zones: towards the tooth surface, that is directly attached to the tooth, and the outer surface of the plaque mass. So here at the tooth surface associated plaque, we have more of gram positive cocci and rods, and as we move towards the outer surface of the plaque, there are more of filamentous microorganisms. Also cocci and rods are present, but more of filaments and spirochetes. So this is the microbial organization of supragingival plaque: gram positive cocci and rods, and towards the outer surface, filaments, spirochetes, and few of the cocci and rods. Gram positive and here gram negative. This shift, this transition of the microbial composition is attributed to the environmental factors. As discussed in detail in ecologic plaque hypothesis, the environmental changes brought about by the initial colonizers will pave way and make the environment favorable for the next subsequent colonizers or the late colonizers. So this is the microbial organization in supragingival plaque, that is gram positive organisms, cocci, rods, and towards the outer surface more of filaments and spirochetes. Talking about the subgingival plaque, we have again tooth associated subgingival plaque, that is mainly root surface associated and the tissue associated. Under tooth associated, we have cervical portion, deeper or middle portion, and apical or the deepest portion. Please mark my words, I am not dividing them into thirds. I am arbitrarily assigning them, demarcating them into cervical, middle, and apical third. More preferably deeper portions and the deepest, that is apical portion. Same classification, same subdivision is on the tissue associated subgingival plaque, that is cervical portion, apical portion. That's as we go deeper, the transition, the stratification or the stratified organization varies. So first we'll discuss the tooth associated subgingival plaque. Again, at the cervical portion, we have predominantly filaments and also some cocci and rods. And as we go deeper, the filaments reduce in the number, and at the deepest portion, that is apical portion, the filaments are virtually absent or nil. Again, here the apical extent of the plaque is demarcated from the epithelium via host cells, mainly neutrophils. And this portion is mainly or predominantly harboring the periopathogens, which are fastidious anaerobes, strict anaerobes, and that is why the deeper pockets are their preferred habitat. The periopathogens are found in the apical portion, from where they can be in direct connectivity with the host tissue and the root surface as well, and carry out their disease activity. So this is about the tooth surface associated subgingival plaque. Coming to the tissue associated subgingival plaque, the primary difference between the two is lack of a definite intermicrobial matrix. Tissue associated subgingival plaque lacks a definite intermicrobial matrix and is predominantly composed of gram-negative microorganisms, filaments, spirochetes, and flagellated rods. For example, streptococci, peptostreptococci are periopathogens such as Porphyromonas gingivalis, Treponema denticola, Tenerina forsythia, and Fusobacterium nucleatum. These all microorganisms are found in tissue-associated subgingival plaque. Host cells are also present within the sulcus, and the bacteria that are present in plaque are also found within the tissues, epithelium, connective tissue and even on the bone. This is their property of host tissue invasion. Remember my previous video on host microbial interaction? For a pathogenic strain, it is important to perform host tissue invasion. It is a key feature to distinguish a pathogenic strain from a non-pathogenic one. Host tissue invasion. So bacteria are also found within the tissues and on the bone. Talking about the stratified organization, the apical third harbors the gram-negative rods and filaments are absent here. The spirochetes are present more. Filaments are more present in the cervical portion. Clear? A brief summary of the composition once again. Supragingival and subgingival. Supragingival, tooth associated, has gram-positive cocci rods, and towards the outer surface we have more of filaments and spirochetes. About the subgingival plaque, tooth associated has filaments in the cervical portion, but as we go deeper, filaments reduce and are virtually absent or nil in the apical portion. The apical portion mainly comprises of the gram-negative microorganisms. And the tissue-associated plaque has a similar stratification, that is periopathogens in the apical portion and filaments in the cervical portion. Plus, the host cells are found within the sulcus and the bacteria from the plaque are also found within the tissues and on the bone. And one more difference between tooth-associated subgingival plaque and the tissue-associated, the lack of intermicrobial matrix. And the clinical importance of understanding this microbial organization is because different plaque has different clinical implications. For example, this supragingival plaque, that is tooth-associated, and this root-associated subgingival plaque are important because they are responsible for calculus formation and the caries, especially root caries. Whereas this marginal plaque, the one which coincides at the margin, is responsible for causing gingivitis, precisely marginal gingivitis. And the main culprit of the entire story, this tissue-associated plaque, because it is in direct contact with the host tissues and causing the host tissue destruction by host tissue invasion and further disease activity, that is evading the host defense mechanism. So, thereby causing periodontal diseases of different clinical forms, different clinical presentations. So, this tissue-associated subgingival plaque is responsible for periodontal diseases in different forms and different clinical presentations. This is the main culprit of periodontal disease. Of all these plaques that we studied, supragingival, marginal and subgingival, again under subgingival, tooth associated, that is root associated, or tissue associated, only tissue associated plaque is responsible for periodontal diseases. So this completes the topic, microbial organization in dental plaque. I hope this topic is clear to you all. If you still have any doubts or any queries, please ask them in the comment section below or mail me at dentalstudiesimplified@gmail.com. Thank you for watching. Study well. Good day. Stay safe.